हेलो फ्रेंड्स, हाउ इज़ द जोश। वेलकम टू यूपीएससी मेड सिंपल चैनल। टुडे इन द सीरीज ऑफ अप्रोच टू द यूपीएससी प्रीलिम्स क्वेश्चंस, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद ऑड मैन आउट अप्रोच। सो बेसिकली दिस अप्रोच इज लाइक इन ऑप्शंस यू विल गेट सम ग्रुप्स, लाइक वन ग्रुप बी और लाइक वन काइंड, सेकेंड ग्रुप ऑफ सेकेंड काइंड। सो दिस groups are not very much similar, so you have to choose one group out of two groups. So we'll see this through UPSC previous year questions. Before that, again I would like to clear it, before going to this approach you should always rely on your knowledge, what you have gained through your preparation, your reading, your understanding of the concepts, then your conceptual clarity, its application wherever possible, then you should look for any logic. And then last, you should look for any common sense kind of thing in the answer. And based on this, you should try to solve any question. If you are not able to solve with these things, then only you should go to the this kind of approaches like odd man out approach. So we'll start with question number 18 from 2012 question. A team of scientists at Brookhaven National Laboratory, including those from India, created the heaviest antimatter, antihelium nucleus. What are the implications of the creation of antimatter? First, it will make mineral prospecting and oil exploration easier and cheaper. Come to the second, it will help probe the possibility of the existence of stars and galaxy made of antimatter. Then it will help understand the evolution of universe. So if you observe, first is talking about mineral prospecting and oil exploration, second is talking about stars, galaxies, antimatter, again third is talking about evolution of the universe. So basically these two are related to space and one is with respect to mineral exploration. This is nothing but a decorative statement. Right. So here odd man out is either you should go for these two or you should go for one, because one and this group don't have much similarity, right? It is talking about space in general and it is talking about mineral exploration, right? So you can easily eliminate option where you will see one either with two or one either with three. So here is one with two and three, it will be gone. Then you will find two and three, and other option as one only and three only, right? If you are including three, why you should not include two? That's why you remove it. But you, if you see mineral prospecting and oil exploration, they are talking about antimatter, so directly it has nothing to do. That's why you will eliminate one, you are left with two and three. Again, if you see antimatter, you will see here antimatter, right? Logical sense, right? It makes sense. That's why answer is B, two and three. Are you getting it? Odd man out is nothing but a group of sentences which has some kind of similarity and a group of sentences which are not very much similar to other group. So you have to find one group, right? Coming to the next question, which of the following can be said to be essentially part of inclusive governance? First statement, permitting the non-banking financial companies, NBFCs, to do banking, good thing. Then establishing effective district planning committee in all districts. Then increasing the government spending on public health. Then strengthening midday meal scheme. So they are talking about which of the following can said to be essentially parts of inclusive governance. So if you see, first is related to economy in general and to be very specific banking. Second is talking about planning committee, that means administration. Third is talking about government spending on public health, again administration. Then strengthening midday meal scheme implementation, again administration. So this is one group and this is one group. First group is talking about economy and banking. Second is talking about administration, or to be very specific, like welfare kind of thing, right? So here with respect to inclusive governance, these 2, 3 and 4 are more relevant, right? And one is odd man out, that's why we will remove one. You remove one, then you need to have 2, 3 and 4. So answer is C. Are you getting it? So inclusive governance, if it would have been financial inclusion, then it would have been first, because it is with respect to financial inclusion and not inclusive governance as such, right? So this option is odd man out. But what sometimes happen, you start overthinking and you think like banking is also part of one kind of governance itself, right? So they will reach to the more people, that will lead to financial inclusion, and if inclusive governance, financial inclusion can be one part. So this kind of overthinking can backfire in actual exam, and that is the thing that happens with most of the veterans. When they get more knowledge, they start overthinking and they make these kind of mistakes, right? That's why answer is 2, 3 and 4. Coming to the next question. The acidification of oceans is increasing. Why is this phenomena a cause of concern? First, the growth and survival of calcareous phytoplankton will be adversely affected. Second, the growth and survival of coral reefs will be adversely affected. Then survival of some animals that have phytoplanktonic larvae will be adversely affected. Fourth, cloud seeding and formation of clouds will be adversely affected. Here if you see acidification of oceans, so first is talking about growth and survival of calcareous phytoplankton will be adversely. Yes, definitely. They are important part of the ocean ecosystem, right? Then growth and survival of coral reefs, again important for ecosystem of ocean. Then survival of some animals that have phytoplanktonic larvae will be affected, definitely. Then come to the fourth, cloud seeding, right? Cloud seeding means artificial clouds you are making. So they are talking acidification affecting cloud seeding. It doesn't make any sense. That's why this is odd man out. Again, one more thing, like this is natural phenomena. Acidification of the oceans, it happens naturally, and this cloud seeding is a kind of artificial phenomena. Yeah, this formation of clouds is a natural, but first part, cloud seeding is artificial. That's why it doesn't make any sense and it is odd man out, right? First 2 and 3. So you will remove 4. 1, 2 and 3. Answer is A. Are you getting? So one option is something different from other. This is one group, this is other group. You are just eliminating the odd man out, right? Moving on to the next question. Other than resistance to pests, what are the prospects for which genetically engineered plants have been created? First, to enable them to withstand drought, good. To increase the nutritive value of the produce, good. To enable them to grow and do photosynthesis in spaceships and space stations, good thing. Then to increase their shelf life. So in all these four options, if you see genetically GM crops, have you heard GM crops being made to enable them to grow and do photosynthesis in spaceships and space station? Doesn't make any sense. If you see 1, 2 and 4, this is one group. They are talking about something with respect to that particular plant, withstand drought, increase nutritive value, increase their shelf life. But this is talking about something which is not much relevant to 1 and 4. That is, they want to grow it in space and space stations, right? So it is called again decorative statement. Right. So here what again can happen? Overthinking. Like you may think it is quite possible with respect to genetically engineered crops that it can be created for space ships and space stations. So you may get trapped here due to this overthinking. That's why you should not get trapped in overthinking. Be simple, think simply and make it correct. So answer is remove 3. Answer is 1, 2 and 4 only. Right? Are you getting? One group is talking about GM crops with respect to their properties. And then it is also with respect to properties, but they are talking about like grow and do photosynthesis in spaceships and space station. That's why this is an odd man out. Out of these two groups, this is other group. First group 1, 2 and 4. Right? Again, if you read the question very carefully, other than resistance to pest, what are the prospects for which GM crops have been created? Right? What's the point in creating GM crops for the spaceships and space stations? It doesn't make any kind of sense. Even logically, it is illogical. Right? Moving on to the next question. from 2017, first question, question number 23. Which of the following are objectives? Read every word, even comma, full stop, very carefully in UPSC exam. Don't consider it is some kind of printing mistake and all. It will not happen, never happen in UPSC, right? So, which of the following are objectives of National Nutrition Mission? First, create awareness relating to malnutrition among pregnant women and lactating mothers. Makes sense. To reduce the incidence of anemia among young children, adolescent girls and women. Makes sense. Then to promote the consumption of millets, coarse cereals and unpolished rice. Good thing. To promote consumption of poultry and eggs. Good protein source. Right. So here, see first two options and last two options. First two statements are to create awareness, then to reduce the incidence, and third and fourth is talking about to promote. So this is one group and this is other group, right? It is talking about objectives: to create awareness, to reduce the incidence of anemia, right? And third is talking promotion of consumption of millets, coarse cereals and unpolished, right? And fourth, consumption of poultry eggs, right? So this is one group, this is other group. Now it makes sense, like if 1, 2, 3 and 4 would have been correct, there would have been option like 1, 2, 3, 4. If there is no option of 1, 2, 3, 4, that means you have to either choose 1 or you have to choose 2. So wherever 1 and 2 will be either 3 and 4, you can cancel it. 1 and 2 with 3, 1 and 2 with 4, you can cancel it. So you have to choose between 1 and 2 only and 3 and 4 only. If you are choosing 1, 2 and 3, why not 4 then? To promote the consumption of millets, coarse cereals and unpolished rice, then why not promote the consumption of poultry eggs? It is again good protein source, right? That's why it doesn't make sense to go with either B or C. So you have to go with either 1 and 2 only or 3 and 4 only. But if you see the objectives, most of the time any scheme will not have objective like to promote consumption of poultry eggs. It can be a kind of component of particular scheme, but not the objective of the scheme, right? That's why you have to remove this second group and answer is 1 and 2 only. Are you getting? Simply, it is odd man out is nothing but two group of statements which are not very similar to other group of statements, and you have to choose between one. So you have to remove one group, and here with respect to these objectives, they doesn't make any sense. It can be provisions, it can be components of particular scheme, but the possibility of objective is very less. That's why you remove this group. Next question from 2018 question paper. First, consider the following countries: Australia, Canada, China, India, Japan, US. Which of the above are among the free trade partners of ASEAN? Right. Which of the following among the above are free trade partners among ASEAN? So see, if you observe these countries, first is Australia, second is Canada, that is US, European, then China, India, Japan, US, again US, American states, right? But all others are Indo-Pacific, and proximity to ASEAN or ASEAN is more with respect to Indo-Pacific, and they are more distant in geographical sense. But question is with respect to economy, free trade agreement, WTO, right? But again, if you see, there is no option 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That means you have to eliminate 2, 4, 4, 4, 4. Here are 4, 4, 4. You have, out of the 6, you have to remove 2. So which 2 is a high probability to remove? That is Canada and US, because these are from American, right? They are far distant from ASEAN. That's why answer should be those which are not including 2 and 6. Here is 2, here is 6, here is 2 and 6. So you are good with C. 1, 3, 4 and 5. Are you getting it? Just because, simply just understand, if there would have been 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, it would have become difficult if you are not aware about it. But out of this 6, you have to choose only 4 options. So which 4 you can choose out of these 6? Those like which are odd man out,
And in this particularly question, odd man is Canada, odd man is US, because these are European and other are Indo-Pacific or more proximity toward the ASEAN, right? That's why answer is C, 1, 2, 1, 3, 4 and 5. Next question, question number 15. Despite being a high saving economy, capital formation may not result in significant increase in output due to. Question is from economy, basic concepts, capital formation. First is weak administrative machinery, illiteracy, high population density, high capital output ratio. So if you observe these options, you will see one group, other group. One is with respect to administration, that means polity, paper 2, GS paper 2, mains. Third is talking about high capital output ratio. It is from economy, right? So odd man out of these four is option D, right? Because it is talking about economy. All others are talking about some, like you can consider it as a society part also, GS paper 1, society part also, right? But it is illiteracy, education paper 2, GS, weak administrative machinery, GS paper 2. This is GS 3, economy, right? So again, this is a kind of odd man out approach, right? But if you see logically also, high saving economy, they are talking capital formation, and only option having something related to capital is only D, right? Even simple logic you can, and capital output is capital, here is output, here is capital, here is output. That's why answer is D, right? But if you know the concept, you can easily reach out to the answer. It is very easy question. But if you are not aware about this concept, and if you have to attempt this question, you can attempt with this odd man out approach. Next question. Question number 59. With reference to circumstances in Indian agriculture, the concept of conservation agriculture assumes significance. Which of the following fall under the conservation agriculture? So see, first, avoiding monoculture practices. Third is adopting minimum tillage. Avoiding cultivation of plantation crops, using crops, using crop residues to cover soil surface, then again adopting spatial and temporal crop sequencing or crop rotation, right? If you observe these five statements, again here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you will not found any option having all five, right? So you have to eliminate at least one, right? So chances to eliminate, first is adopting is a positive oriented, using crop residue positive oriented, adopting positive oriented, removing first, it is avoiding the monoculture is a negative tone, avoiding the negative, in the sense escapist, only these one and three makes one group, and other like 2, 4 and 5 makes other group. So if you have to choose between two groups, you have to either go with one group or 2, 4 and 5. Is there any group having 1 and 3? There is no 1 and 3. That's why you have to choose 2, 4 and 5. So answer is C. One more thing, like wherever there will be 1, 3 with either of these three, 1, 3, 4, you can remove. 1, 3 with 5, you can remove. 1, 3 again with 5, you can remove. You are left with only C. So here simple odd man, it is avoiding, and here adopting using crop residues. Are you getting? Actually, this is again simple question. Those who know the concept of conservation agriculture, because it based on three important principles: adopting minimum tillage, using crop residues, and adopting spatial and temporal crop sequencing or crop rotation, right? These three principles of conservation agriculture. Moving on to the next question, consider the following. The Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has announced minimum support price for which of the above, MSP. Again, very difficult question. Areca nut, barley, coffee, finger millet, groundnut, sesamum, turmeric. So if you see areca nut and coffee, these are plantation crops. And others are food crops, or what you call as cereal and all regular crops. But these are plantation crops, areca nut and coffee. Here you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's why again it will become very difficult. But if you observe it, so areca nut and coffee, these are plantation crops, other crops kind of food crops. So you can make two groups, 1 and 3, and remaining is the rest. These are two groups. So you can easily net option where there will be 1, 3 with other, 1, 3 with 7, then 2, 4, 5, 6, no, 1, 3 with 6, 1, 3 with others, you can remove, you are reached to the B, 2, 4, 5 and 6 only, right? Here again you can use this odd man out approach. You are just removing one group of options or statements which are not very similar to other group of statements. Next, consider the following items: cereal grains hurled, chicken eggs cooked, fish processed and canned, newspapers containing advertising material. Which of the above items is obligatory are exempted under GST? Again, very difficult question. So if you observe this carefully, this is cereal grains hurled. That means if you remove upper part of the cereals, so you can see it in regular grocery shops. Then chicken eggs cooked, you will see on roadside stalls. But if you see fish processed and canned, you will see only in some, sorry, in malls, some what we call as highly it is something which is different. Fish processed and canned, you will never see in a roadside, you will never see in local grocery shops this food processed and canned. You will only mostly see in malls, like in Bangalore, if you see it is a Mantri mall, you will see it food processed and canned. And again, newspaper containing advertising material, it can be to the everyone's house, right? So if you observe these, 1, 2 and 4 makes one group, and third is a one separate group. So chances, right, that you can remove these three and you can choose 1, 2 and 4, because exempted means there will be no GST, its price will be less. So it is a welfare kind of or positive oriented government approach or welfare approach, where government will promote welfare of the common people, common citizens, or those who are in a need. So those who are in need will be those people who will eat this chicken eggs cooked on the roadside, and those people local grocery shop, those people who are affording to eat this processed feed and canned fish in malls, there is no need to give some kind of concession to them. That's why they will not be exempted under the GST. This is the logic behind to remove this odd man out. If you remove 3, you are left with 1, 2 and 4. Answer is C. Right. Coming to the questions from 2019. Consider the following statements. A digital signature is an electronic record that identifies and certifying authority issuing it, then used to serve as a proof of identity of an individual to access information or server on internet. Third, an electronic method of signing an electronic document and ensuring that the original content is unchanged. Again, very difficult question. If you carefully observe these three statements, first two are talking about identification and third is talking about signing. And if it is a digital signature, that means something which you do on physically on paper, you are doing digitally on cyberspace or platform like this, right? So signature makes sense. Signing is a digital signature. You are signing electronic document, again digital signature makes sense. That's why this is one group and this is other group. First group of 1 and 2 and second group having third statement. So you can easily remove where there will be 1 and 2 with 3. 1 and 2 with 3. Then which having 2 and 3, you can easily remove. You are either left with these 1 only or 3 only. But 1 only is talking about identification of the certifying authority. But purpose of this digital signature is not that. It is just an signing an electronic document, right? That's why answer is C. Simply, you should think. If you start overthinking it, you might think like digital signature, it may identify certifying authority. And you again overthink. You will think like it is a proof of identity also, who has signed it, right? But this is not the correct answer. Answer is 3 only. Coming to the last question from this odd man out series. Come to the question number 98 from 2019. Which of the following are reasons for the occurrence of multi-drug resistance in microbial pathogens in India? That is drug resistance pathogens. First, genetic predisposition of some people. taking incorrect doses of antibiotics to cure diseases, then using antibiotics in livestock farming, then multiple chronic diseases in some people. So if you carefully observe, it is talking very mild. Fourth is again very mild because it's talking about some people. Second is very assertive, taking incorrect doses of antibiotics to cure, again using antibiotics, right? So you will easily find two groups having 1 and 4 and having 2 and 3. So here odd man out will be either 1 and 4 or it will be 2 and 3, right? So you have to choose option where either it will be 1 and 4 or 2 and 3. So if you observe carefully, 1 and 2, so it is odd man out, is mixing with others. Then 2 and 3, yeah, makes sense, it is there. Then 1 and 4, but there is 3. Again 2, 3 and 4 doesn't make sense. Answer is B, 2 and 3, because only this group is given in the option. It would have been difficult, it would have been 1 and 4, right, for the common people. But for medicos it is very easy question because they are very much aware about this multi-drug resistance in microbial pathogens, right? So this is with respect to odd man out approach, right? So you can give a thought to this. Definitely if you are not able to solve any question with respect based upon your understanding, your conceptual clarity and knowledge, right? So we have started one channel for this UPSC Made Simple. You can join. I will share the link in the description below, right? Thank you very much.